entrepreneurship journey from TP to Bitcoin to hybrid blockchain. Mr. Yeo, please.
Sorry, I have to speak from the podium, not that I prefer it, but I was advised the mic would run off battery halfway. So being conservative, being a tech guy, I decided to have a fail-safe solution being the podium. So wire is better than wireless in this case. We have another mic, so back up this here. So, without further ado, too many small words, so I'll just point at the pictures. After I graduated in SIP from Temasek Poly, I was attached. I started my own consulting company and was had a privilege to lead Singapore's first mega project, which is a multi-billion dollar, 1.7 billion at a time, Samsung mega project, ERP. The downside to that is after that, you suddenly your career is you reach a high-paying project and you can go into a $300,000 ERP project. And also during then, it was 2008, it was Lehman Brothers. There were no more large-scale multi-million dollar ERP projects. So I went to Indonesia and started my internet cafe. I raised $250,000 from investors and did an internet cafe, 24 hours, 300 computers, 8,000 square feet in 3 shop houses. So it was happy days then, because literally every day was fun and games. And things went on well until the iPhone 3 came out and nobody wanted to go to the land shop anymore. Basically, Indonesia moved from 56K modem internet speed right directly into 3G. That's a huge leapfrog. So the whole macro environment changed. And what to do when you already sold 6 months of time coupons in advance, but nobody wants to come. So we decided to just leave the business open and let people to claim their credits to honor our goodwill. And through that business decision, it gave us a blessing because it got us thinking, what do you do when 300 computers are at your disposal and what do you do with it? So we started mining Bitcoin in 2009. So at this point right now, you must be thinking, wow, I must be very, very loaded. But the downside was, at an internet cafe, when we tried this experiment for about a few days using 300 computers, the computer has it's called panda freeze. So when you turn off the power, or if there's a trip, you restore back to the original condition. So all the Bitcoins were wiped, and after we did the calculation, it didn't pay for the electricity, we stopped mining Bitcoin. It was only 1 week in 2009 that I mined Bitcoin. So that's the real story. And we changed to mining something different. We mined War of Warcraft, the game, the gold currency. So we had 300 bots farming the World of Warcraft, and that made more money than. So from there, after Batam, I was privileged to join Toyota and did their first ERP project that oversaw $2 trillion of sales annually. This is a just-in-time custom-made ordering system where if, let's say, you're in the Middle East, you order a new Alpha, and the parts were shipped from Japan and assembled in Thailand and shipped over to the UAE. And yeah, the system oversaw $2 trillion. And because of that, I joined to Dentsu, which acquired a UK media company for $5 billion. And strangely enough, after the acquisition, the Japanese yen dropped 70%. So talk about currency manipulation. It's the span of 3 years. So due to that, I'm very privileged to travel to many different parts of the world on the same advertising industry, meet different CEOs, and integrate them onto the same IT platform, which kind of brings me back to where I am now, having completed our XinFin ICO. An ICO is an initial coin offering. We have just raised about close to $40 million by selling 6 billion tokens, which is 6% of our total token supply, giving a valuation of the company at about almost $500 million. That's a lot of numbers, but none of it really matters, because in using smart contract, we have locked our supply to only give out 5% per year, so that we're not running away with the coins or trying to flood an argument or nothing. We're basically, at our heart, we're just like an open source foundation, like a Linux foundation, where we created a blockchain protocol to change the world and make it a better place. But more about that later. Where was I? So after Toyota and after Dentsu integration, the Bitcoin price reached a new peak of $1,200 in December 2013. That brought my attention, and I decided to take action on it again. And instead of Bitcoin, I was mined. I raised $1.5 million by first getting a PIC pre-approval from the government. A PIC pre-approval meant that government will subsidize 70% of the investment that we make in servers. At the time, it was ASIC mining server. 70% of that is literally like a government paying to bring money. Pretty good. So they raised $1.5 million. We built in the picture a 1 megawatt facility that represented 5 to 10% of the global hash rate in Singapore. This was 2014, 2015, very much earlier. After we built it, we accumulated about 1 million Litecoins, and it was mining to the tune of 100,000 Litecoins per month. In today's net present value of that coin, 1 million Litecoins is about $400 million right now. But like they say, the more you lose, the more you stand to recover, right? If you recover from it. So after being $400 million poorer, or losing the opportunity of being $400 million rich, what happened was, from the high price of 1,200, China decided to ban Bitcoin. That was the first ban. The reason was really the end time that they have tried to ban Bitcoin. So 1,002 Bitcoin dropped all the way to $200. So imagine, in any industry that you're in, be it F&B or be it in accounting, the industry suddenly shrinks by 600%. It's Armageddon, and that happened to me. With an overhead of, because you're running a lot of electricity, 1 megawatt, we're paying like 250,000 as on average in electrical bill. 250,000. So no joke. And suddenly your top line shrinks by 600%, you're out of option, and the government now tells you, yes, you had a pre-approval for PIC, we change our rules. So maybe I should actually take this conversation offline. Many people here, but eventually we tried to restructure, because we have a group structure, and we tried to restructure it into individual companies, different owners, which originally that was what they were. But the market crashed before that. And then to add, so instead of first whammy was the price, second one was the PIC, the third whammy was the landlord had the lease expiring in 6 months. So we had no choice, we had to move to China, and as probably all know in the news currently, China also banned mine, so we're on the move again. So it's a very fluid industry, and during mining, we were located in the western part of Singapore in Joo Koon, near the oil refinery, or you can also call it, all the incinerators are there. So if you spend a long enough time, because if you can't see the picture, maybe I can show a bigger picture later. The size of the fan, extractor fan, because we converted a warehouse, a high ceiling warehouse, 6 meter high ceiling, to this mining farm, the extractor fan in the West, because of the high volume of air going through, after working in the location for like 10-20 hours, your nostrils are full of snot, like black oily snot, like where this come from. So it's, and on the machines you can see the oil condensing. Yeah, it's really bad air. No black property in the West. So moving on, since moving the mining operation out of Singapore, I decided that the blockchain is where my calling was and what I wanted to advocate. We decided to move into exploring the blockchain beyond mining. No need mining, no need to work in like a mine-like condition and having your lungs filled with oily stuff, right? So we invented the first hybrid blockchain that didn't need mining. That was in 2016. And in 2016, we represented Singapore FinTech Bootcamp to go to Mumbai and present our private blockchain technology to banks like ICICI Bank, Yes Bank, Tata Group. And from there, I met my co-founders at XinFin. Our booth is outside later. If you have more questions, also you can pointers. A few other ICOs that I represent would be XinFin. That was the one I mentioned. And the next one is Energy Echo Chain. Energy Echo Chain is a Hong Kong Chinese company. Parent company built a $5 billion gas pipe in Papua New Guinea. They recently did a private sale of their ICO and raised about $50 million. They're a blockchain company to do settlement of the energy industry using blockchain and smart contracts. Another business we created is ICO Bitcoins. So one of my hobbies at night is, if I'm not doing anything else, is I think of names to register. That's a side hobby, which turned out to be quite profitable. Because you look at the keywords for crypto, the top keywords are Bitcoin, ICOs, and Ethereum, but every time people spell Ethereum wrong. So you can't register Ethereum very well. So we decided to settle at ICO Bitcoins. So the domain name bitcoin.com was worth $5 million in 2013. Now it's gone, multiple. And the CEO of bitcoin.com, Roger Ver, also dubbed as Bitcoin Jesus, is our advisor on XinFin. Beyond ICO Bitcoin, ICO Bitcoin is a crypto exchange dealing with fiat and crypto. Alpha Exchange is a crypto-to-crypto exchange. And TradeFinex is, we didn't plan this, but it's very similar to what Zmart is doing, but on the blockchain. We are revolutionizing supply chain globally using blockchain technology. So it's a platform allowing suppliers and buyers and financiers to post their requirements online, and we tie it up using a smart contract. We do the whole cycle from idea to delivery to support. Okay, so yeah, those should have clicked this slide earlier. So I'll just fast forward to the last one, or just quickly run through again. So DP and BIT, we have to do a Samsung project, then Internet Cafe, and Toyota, and Dentsu, and mining, R&D, blockchain tech, yes. And from XinFin, yes. So we recently completed our ICO. We started our ICO on 15th of February 2018, when I was having a holiday with my family in Southeast Asia. Decided to start the ICO. In the 1980s, there was a stock market boom where every commoner would be on the streets queuing up for pink sheets to buy into the stock market. And this trend was almost replicated in Korea, where Obasan, deposit mortgages, the house, takes bags of cash, goes down the street along the gunman, and buys some ICO token, which she doesn't know what is it about. They just want to buy crypto, that's it. So that's why Korea government is doing a lot of regulation to regulate the real companies that have the technology, that are a real technology company, and raising funds to expand, versus the private money teams that are just running a Ponzi. Two months ago at Temasek Gasong, I had a seminar similar to this where a couple of hundred people signed up, and one of the predictions I made then was, the question asked from the audience was, how do you make money from blockchain? Is it subscribing to ICO, is it buying Bitcoin? And my frank answer was, if you read one of the books of investing, is you divide your wealth into three buckets. One is long term, one is short term, one is cash for day to day survival. You do not put all of it into one basket. If I wanted to guess, I would buy probably top 10, top 20, top 50 tokens, and probably put $100, very small in each one. And still, on average, you get a very good return. However, what I said was, do not buy into hype. Buying into hype means you do not understand what the business is about. You do not know who the founders are, you do not see delivery of any real technology, and worse still, if they are trying to offer you an interest-based return, that or you recommend a friend, they give you more interest, and that was exactly what happened. In a few weeks after that the talk, that seminar, Bitcoin collapsed. The price of Bitcoin was plunging, and then Bitcoin disappeared and vanished into thin air. $2 billion worth of the market. And also during that seminar, someone asked me, is it okay to go to Xinfin, buy a few graphics card, and start mining? I said, if you've tried it before, or if you have little children at home, be careful of their fingers, poking in a fan, the card, and it's noisy, it's hot, and ultimately you're not making money, because at the point of buying your equipment, that amount had you bought into token, you will make your return of capital faster than playing with the toy that becomes a white elephant at home. So let me go back to what is an ICO. An ICO is an event which a new cryptocurrency project sells part of its token supply to early adopters and enthusiasts in exchange for money today. An ICO is a way provides a way for cryptocurrency project creators to raise money for their operations, and most ICOs raise money in Bitcoin or other cryptocurrencies. So this is a simple chart based on May 2016 versus May 2017. Had you bought gold, personally I bought some gold before and I lost a lot of money, so I don't recommend gold. Gold would give you negative 12% if you bought in May 2016 and you compare the performance in May 2017. HSI is the Hong Kong Stock Index. If you bought some stocks, it will make you 15%. If you had bought Bitcoin in May 2016, it will make you 316% by the time in May 2017. And Ethereum would make you 2,000%. So Ethereum started from $20 at the time in May 2016. And by the May 2017, it had gone to $400, which is still lower than today's price of $500. Between May 2017 to the recent talk in, say, January 2018, it went from $400 to $1,500. It's crazy. It's even crazy because the founder of Ethereum came up and said, "Oh, cryptocurrency is,
This year is the year of 2018. We see Bitcoin consolidation. Still, the market cap would exceed $1 trillion, and it will become more and more established. We see IPO companies launching their ICOs. We see enterprises launching their ICOs. So you see, Bitcoin then was under $4,000. I received a phone call last few days from friends calling, hey, Bitcoin crashed a lot, it went from 1,002 to 8,000 now. I said, it's still quite high. I mean, only a few months ago, it was only 4,000. Yeah. So, if we did some analysis, the top 30 cryptos held 90%, and the Bitcoin dominance then was 50%. Today, the Bitcoin dominance is less than 50% at 34%, and the total market cap is $650 billion. Right now, we're still around those numbers. We have established a new floor, and the only way up is to cross $1 trillion. So the government has started to clamp down, started to regulate. China implemented the Great Firewall of China on all crypto. Still a lot of Chinese are investing, because in an environment like China where stock market, if the market is crashing, you get jailed if you sell the stock, if you sell too much. Property bubble is really 20 times price of property has grown in Shenzhen and Beijing. And you can the last one holding the ball. So they invest in crypto. Investment of ICOs has exceeded, fundraising on ICOs has exceeded what VCs and angel investment firms are able to finance in the market. A Singapore company named 10X raised $60 million based on the idea that you can use a credit card. One day you can use a credit card and spend crypto. True to the name 10X, after raising $60 million, the market cap went to $600 million in 2 months. I didn't track them, so these are just illustrations of things that actually happened. Next is Qtum. Qtum is a Chinese company, also in mining, like my previous venture, and they came to Singapore and they did the ICO, and they say they have some grand vision using the Bitcoin network to deploy for enterprise. But we all know that the Bitcoin network is too congested and too slow for enterprise use. Nevertheless, they still raise $1 billion. The next is OMG. Their ticker symbol is OMG, so quite cool. They raised about $1.2 billion. IOTA. It's a real-time blockchain, and they raised about $3 billion. And Singapore is the top three countries globally in generation three, we've moved beyond mining. There's no more mining. So from this, this was what I did in 2014, 2015, to this, no more mining. I'll skip the demo for today. This takes a lot long. Ethereum is using graphics card to do the mining. So yeah, I understand the outside foyer there's a booth by NVIDIA. NVIDIA stocks actually went up a lot because of crypto and people buying their cards to do mining. But yeah, no more mining in the future. In generation three, enterprise-ready hybrid blockchains, which are proof of stake based, do not require any form of mining. This is already evident in the other enterprise-based token called Ripple. Ripple is also in the top five of the capitalization for coin market cap. Okay, I'll play this video. So other than XDC, we built a platform that is powered by XDC called TradeFinex that allows suppliers, project owners, and financiers put their requirements on this platform. And using this blockchain technology, you put it in the smart contract, you become the escrow, and trade becomes easy. So TradeFinex provides project financing, wallet services, and platform licensing opportunities. At our heart, we ask ourselves, why what this problem. Globally, $27 trillion worth of annual infrastructure investments do not get funded. Typically, in developing countries, perhaps there's too much corruption, perhaps there's too much political agenda. For example, if I'm a developing country, I need to borrow from IMF, from ADB, Japan, or from EIB, China. There are different requirements. If it is a China fund, I need to buy, procure their Chinese technology, Chinese worker, as well as Chinese loan, and perhaps there may be political tension. So using blockchain technology, we remove all of that. If I'm a developing country, Indonesia, I could choose a Korean company, provide the technology, I can get my funding from via P2P on this platform for those that bought the token. It could be from Japan or Africa, and the project gets funded, and everyone trusts each other because everything is written into the token, the contract, as well. So when you buy this token, you are funding total power plant in, say, for example, Indonesia or Cambodia. And at any point in time, your position is liquid because your token is tradable. So it's the best of both worlds and only made possible with this new technology innovation. So a few vectors that we looked into is financing waste recycling plants, solar power, water, industrial automation, peer-to-peer payment solutions, and even a method of credit using blockchain. So we financed a solar power farm, we financed clean projects, waste recycling projects as well as enabling easier cross-border trade. We've also created easy peer-to-peer transfer, especially for emergency situations. Our aim is to work with different universities, financial institutions, business partners, companies, governments, startups, EDBs, as well as the local communities. At TP, we have been accepted into the incubation space to hold an office there, and to incubate the students by allowing them to use our open source protocol, as well as creating a startup fund to fund such selected ideas that qualify. So these are the typical LI process. So using the XinFin protocol, we can digitize any asset, be it a barrel of oil, be it a kilowatt of energy, be it a fraction of a private property, HDB, not to free yourself, so only private property. You can digitize that asset even before it's built. Let's say a DC-30 wants to build a new project in Laos or Cambodia, and we wanted to crowdfund it. We can tokenize it and put it in trade on the platform. All that is made possible. And a QR payment network, because of our private blockchain speed, we can literally do what Alipay does using QR, and the settlement is instant, whereas on these traditional payment systems, it's usually T+1 or T+14, up to T+14 where they take 1 to 2 weeks to pay you back your money. And because of our instant settlement systems and technology, we are able to do remittance. These are all bank-related activities that we can improve on using blockchain technology. So with internet, people would, one of the first things that came up was e-commerce. That was the trend when internet first came up. That's how Alibaba was built. Was how Taobao Mall was built. With blockchain technology, this goes into overdrive. Users not depend on the platform to get paid. Immediately they can get paid. Immediately your reputation is there. Immediately people know So in mining, the verification is done by individual computers. In trusted network, the verification, you don't need miners, you just need trusted partners. That's the best I can say. Maybe one more question. So I should also put a little advertisement as well. So a famous cryptocurrency investor guru, name of Cliff High. If you Google him, you can find Cliff High. He has done an independent research about our ICO, which is XinFin or ICO. Our current token price is 0.006, which is 0.6 cents, right? Being the only hybrid blockchain technology with smart contract in the market out there right now. So the only other one that has smart contract in the top 10 is Ethereum, and they've gone, the high price was $1,500, the low price now is about $500. Ours is 0.6 cents, which is 0.006. Yeah, so Cliff had literally said that, and also on our advisor team, is Roger Ver, is dubbed as Bitcoin Jesus. He's gone around literally giving out Bitcoins, and that's why people call him Bitcoin Jesus early on. But yeah, maybe because of that, of karma, and he created Bitcoin Cash, and it's worth $57 billion. He's our